The Philippines grid operator says there is enough power supply for the rest of the year. NGCP gave this assurance even after the grids of Luzon and Visayas were recently placed on alert due to the sizzling weather that caused energy demand to spike. It, however, admits more work needs to be done to improve the power sector.
We've been issuing grid status alerts over the Visayas and Luzon for the past couple of years now, maybe 3, 4, 5 years consecutively. Although there is no persistent power supply shortage, you do feel it during the summer or shortly after summer. And that's indicative that for the general portions of the year, there is enough power supply. It's indicative that your excess is thinning because then you're vulnerable to heat, you're vulnerable to unplanned maintenance shutdowns. So I think maybe it's really an indication that we have to go back to the drawing board in terms of ensuring that we have a more resilient power system.
The Luzon grid will be under red and yellow alerts again today with 4 plants on forced outages. Mindanao's grid will also be under a yellow alert from 10 in the morning to 4 in the afternoon. Philippine statesman and human rights defender Rene Sagisag has passed away. He was 84. The former senator was among the leading opposition figures during the martial law era and was among those imprisoned at the start of the military regime. Sagisag served as presidential spokesman under the Corazon Aquino administration. He served in the upper chamber from 1987 to 1992. In a statement, his family says, as they mourn his passing, they take solace in the enduring impact of his legacy. Sagisag's family also remembered him as a dedicated public servant and a tireless human rights advocate who fought for justice, truth, and democracy. Well, tributes pouring in for Sagisag. Human rights lawyer and former House lawmaker Erin Tanyada remembers how Sagisag committed his life to protecting human rights. Tanyada described him as a family man and a nationalist who was at the forefront of the people's fight against the dictatorship of the late President Ferdinand Marcos Sr. Tanyada also shared this photo of Sagisag and his father, former Senator Wigberto Tanyada, taken just last April 9th when they were both recognized by the Bantayog ng Mga Bayani Foundation for their efforts in fighting the Marcos Sr.'s regime. Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri also mourning Sagisag's death in a statement. Zubiri lauded how the former senator lived out the principle that those who have less in life should have more in law. He added, Sagisag will leave an indelible mark as a true statesman. Former Senate President Franklin Tiridon meanwhile called Sagisag a model public servant. He notes Sagisag's principles on morality was unbending.